sequence of switches turned on or off would represent any number. He started to build the switches by hand. He took metal sheets. And then he took a saw and he made attempted structures. He had about 30,000 metal sheets. One by one, Zuther turned the sheets into the thousands of intricate metal switches that would create his binary sequences. However, if even one switch was out of alignment, none of them would work. He had to find a better way. But world events threatened to derail his entire project. In 1939, Konrad Zuse was called up to fight for Hitler. But instead of heading for the front lines, Zuse managed to work in aerodynamics for the German Air Force. He tried to convince them about his computer concept, but they didn't see a use for it. So Zuse persevered on his own, after work, then he came up with a brilliant solution to replace the cumbersome mechanical switches. He salvaged electrical relays from old telephones and used them instead. The relays became switches that would create his binary sequences. It was the major turning point for Zeus's conception. No more awkward moving parts, just the efficient hum of electricity. December 1941, the computer was finished. 6 years of work,